First, do a safety check to ensure the gun is empty. Lock the bolt. Move the bolt stop lever to the vertical position to move the bolt stop down. Remove the faux muzzle brake. Remove the rubber O-ring. I'll show you the correct size replacement for this later in the video. Remove the handguard cap nut. And remove the handguard. Remove the barrel nut. Remove the barrel by gently releasing the bolt, but not all the way. Grab the front of the barrel and place your thumb on the operational rod and nudge the barrel out while fully releasing the bolt. Remove the gas piston. Grab the bolt carrier and operational spring and pull them back slightly, just enough to align the notches of the bolt and bolt carrier, even with the bolt handle, and pull the bolt handle out. Then you can slide the bolt carrier group and operational spring out and disassemble the group. To separate the upper and lower, you will need to remove the upper retention bolt using a 1/2-inch socket with a 3/8-inch drive, a ratchet, and a 10 or 12-inch extension. So first you remove the butt pad using a Phillips screwdriver. Then attach the socket to the extension and set it onto the bolt by hand. I'm using a 12-inch extension, and you can see how much room I have to handle the extension. A 10-inch extension will work just fine, but the 12-inch does make it a little bit easier. Then attach the ratchet and remove the retention bolt. And now you can separate the upper from the lower. This is the replacement O-ring that I found in the plumbing department at Lowe's. This is a number 40 O-ring with a 3/4-inch outer diameter by 5/8-inch inner diameter by 1/16-inch thickness. And there were 10 pieces in here. And as you can see, it's a perfect replacement fit for the O-ring. These were $2.34. To begin reassembly, first put the 1/2-inch socket onto the extension and put the upper receiver retention bolt into the socket and feed it through the hole in the lower. Then place the upper onto the lower, line it up, and you can begin to screw them back together by hand. I find doing it this way is a lot easier than starting this with the ratchet attached. Then attach the ratchet and tighten the bolt. Replace the butt pad. Put the bolt carrier group back together. And slide the operational rod through the spring and bolt fixing tube. Slide the bolt into the upper. Line up the notches of the bolt and the bolt carrier and insert the charging handle. Put the gas piston back onto the barrel. Set the bolt to be even with the front of the upper. Slide the operational rod through the gas piston. Line up the notch on the bolt with the barrel and push the barrel into the upper until it locks in. Pull the bolt back slightly and replace the barrel nut. Replace the handguard and the handguard cap. Then replace the handguard cap nut. Put the rubber O-ring back onto the front of the barrel and replace the full muzzle brake. Pull the bolt back and set the bolt stop back into the horizontal position. And you're done. I hope this video helped. Thanks for watching and liking. Stay free, my friends.